Hi, I'm Nick Van Puer. We're about to go on a virtual field trip through the Owens Valley, and we're going to make a number of stops here.
Here we are at the parking lot for our first stop at Fossil Falls. I want to apologize for the voiceover here. It was a very windy day when I was recording this. If you guys are driving up from LA towards Mammoth, you'll often see this area with dark rocks and sort of a conical volcano. And this area is covered by basaltic lava that erupted over the last several hundred thousand years. But at any rate, if you come here, the main attraction here is something called Fossil Falls. It's a very short hike, maybe a quarter mile, something like that. Unless it's summer and extremely hot, it's a pretty trivial hike. And so the first thing you'll see when you start heading down the trail here is that there's all this black, jagged lava around you. And this is a type of lava called and this right here came out of the cinder cone off to our left, which is called Red Hill, that erupted about 140,000 years ago. And part of the reason for the very rough surface texture on the here is that basically as lava flows, it's cooling on the top surface against the air. And that tends to make it, cool down into solid rock and harden. But it's still flowing in the middle, so that breaks up that crust on the surface into little chunks. And those chunks keep rolling around, and you get this, basically end up with this flow with this very rough, chunky surface on top. Of course, in this area, this flow has also been sitting here for over 100,000 years eroding, so that's modified its surface a little bit. But another thing we can see here is the straight front of the Sierra Nevada mountains off to the west of us. And the reason though that mountain front is so straight is because it's marked by a big normal fault. And that fault has, for the last 3 million years approximately, lifted up the Sierra Nevada mountains, and then it's dropped down the valley, the Owens Valley to the right.
So here we are at a slightly better vantage point. So first thing you can see is that the lava fields are quite extensive. Sorry about the wind noise here. And so the lava fields extend for many square miles. Another thing you'll see as you look out in those hills over there is there are a lot more volcanic rocks. I'll have to show you a close-in because on the GoPro it's very zoomed out. But all the dark hills there are all also older lava flows. And then also some of the light-colored sort of conical hills that are flat-topped. There's one out that way. There's another couple back out that way. And so all the dark rocks are all older basalt flows. And all the light sort of conical hills are rhyolite flows. So rhyolite is a different type of lava that's much thicker, much more rich in the element silicon. And so there's actually been magmatic activity going on in this area for about 6 million years intermittently. And furthermore, people who have done various sorts of science experiments have shown that there is today still a big chamber of magma underground. So lots of a big body of not completely molten rock, but partially molten rock, where there's crystals, and then in between the crystals is liquid magma. But that's several miles below the surface there. But it's a body that's a few miles across and a few miles deep. So this is a giant blob of partially molten rock lies down a couple miles down underneath the hills just to our east. And occasionally some of that magma leaks up to the surface and creates these lava flows. And so again, there's these two different types. There's this really dark stuff is this basalt. Basically, that's the type of melt that you get straight out of the mantle in the normal course of the plate tectonics. And then when that basalt rises up out of the mantle into the crust, sometimes it will melt the pre-existing crust, which is more silica rich. And when it melts that crust, you get basically a rhyolite, which makes these steeper conical hills. Now you might ask, well, why is there magma coming out of the mantle here at all? And There are a couple possible answers to that.
One reason is that we're right next to the Sierra Nevada mountains here. Remember I said there was a big fault along the mountain front there. And in addition to causing the uplift of the mountain, that fault is also causing east-west extension across the Owens Valley. And if the ground is extending at the surface, it also has to be extending below in the mantle. And that means that new hot mantle material needs to rise up below the ground to fill that space. And the mantle is not liquid, but it's solid, but it's sort of a hot and putty-like at the temperature's like. But as that rises up, it loses pressure, and that actually causes it to melt. Another reason might have to do with the dripping off or delamination of dense material off the bottom of the Sierra Nevada. But that's a more complicated story, and I don't want to go into that right now.
The main sort of tourist attraction here at Fossil Falls is actually down over this way. If you look, there's sort of an end of the cliffs of basalt here, and there's a sort of dry channel here. This dry channel here is actually the prehistoric course of the Owens River. So there used to be a significant river here in winter times. It hasn't really flowed since the last ice age. During the ice ages, there's more moisture getting out into the desert here, and so there would have actually been a river flowing through here. And this river flowed over the edge of the basalt flow and then went down and basically made a big waterfall. And so this site is known as Fossil Falls because there actually used to be a big waterfall. And so we'll go down there in a moment and you'll see the sort of pitted nature of the rock that's where it's been eroded out and carved into some fantastic forms by the erosion of that waterfall. Okay, so here we are at the lip of the falls, and already you can see that the rocks are forming all these sort of contorted shapes with sort of these fluted layers, and you can actually see the direction the water flows from the way the little streaks in the rock are all pointing one direction. And you can tell from the size of these features, this must have been a pretty big and substantial river coming through here. You see how, again, all these things are all rounded off on the top side. So you can see the force of the water here must have been tremendous. The other thing you'll see is these random round potholes. And so what all these deep holes are, is places where basically rocks have gotten, have been churned around in circles by the action of the water. So basically once you get one little tiny pothole with a few rocks in it, the power of the river basically makes a little vortex, and the stones get dragged around in circles in that, and then that those rocks actually then grind out the bottom of the hole deeper. So that's a classic sign of erosion by a river. And so if you look down here, this waterfall, it starts off as a series of these potholes. Eventually, if you keep going down there, there's like a 20-foot drop that is not safely passable. But all in all, the river drops, I don't know, like maybe 60 feet or 20 meters, something like that. Anyway, it's a fun place to explore. Just if you come out here, be careful. The rocks are very slippery.